Well, welcome back to our little bakery in Saint-Tropez. I'm going to be working on this basket of croissants in this video. First of all, we're going to do our basket, and we'll fill it with the croissants. These are mixtures of my mud, which is two parts of ultramarine blue and one part of alizarin crimson. And I first just want to get a basic coat on my basket. I use a little bit of ultramarine blue plus white as we go back around the corner there. The cool of the blue makes that recede. It makes the basket go feel round. It's a little bit too light, so I'll add a little bit more ultramarine blue into that. Now I'm going to have grapes here kind of coming over the counter, so I just work around that. Now the light's coming into the painting from the left, so this part of the basket gets a little bit lighter. And it's a wicker basket. So what I do is, using my mixture of mud plus liquid, I start putting the upright ribs of the basket in. With that dark mixture. As the basket goes around, the ribs get closer. Now the base of the basket is actually comes around. Goes out a little bit there. And it goes in here behind the grapes. I pulled down a little bit over my countertop. I'd originally sketched this in with my mud plus liquid. And so that sketch is dry, so I can just go back with a clean brush. I wipe it with tissue, swish it around in the thinner and wipe it with tissue. And I can go back and erase any errant lines. Doesn't matter on my grapes because I'm going to be painting those over the basket. But now this lip of the basket here on the bottom catches a little bit of light along there. And it's a little lighter. I'm going to make that go up a little bit higher so it's not in line with that back edge of the counter. And it's going to be a little, I'm going to add a little of my ultramarine blue on this side to make that go back. And then it'll be darker here. And then my lip, again. And I can use, this is my square bright brush, and I can use it flat to make this little thin line along the top here. I had a very good question the other day. Someone asked me, what's the difference between the bright brush and the flat? The flat also has a square end, like the bright brush, but the bristles are quite a bit longer. And so that makes the brush a little more flexible. I like the shorter bright brush because I can control the brush strokes better. Particularly when I'm doing something, you know, with a fine like this, or if I want to use the corner of the brush possibly to make flower petals or something like that. So that's why I prefer the bright as opposed to the flats. Now, to make the wicker that goes in between, I use, again, the flat edge of my brush. And I'll start over on this side so you can see. I'm going to use a little bit of my blue back here so that basket rounds out. And I start just putting my wicker in there. Now, as I come around, I'm going to start, this is going to be a little bit warmer. Well, I think it's going to be warmer. Start coming around. And I alternate these. Little, you can see I go in between because that the wicker is woven, and so those little brush strokes go in between. This comes into the light. They're in shadow up here under the little napkin that's in the croissant basket. And I get these a little bit darker up here as we go up. It's too dark. And these are mixes of my mud plus ultramarine blue plus white plus cadmium orange. And I want this lighter as we come around. But you can see how that makes that look like wicker. It's woven. One more in there. And that's how I make my wicker basket. And now as it goes back around, then it gets cooler, goes into the blue, and I get less distinct because I want this to just kind of drop back. Maybe a little bit too light there, but. And then the top edge of that basket is also woven. And it's on a, the wicker goes on kind of a diagonal. And the handles. Now this kind of comes in at a diagonal, and I can just, using my mud mixture, mud plus liquid, I can just make those striations into that. Now this is going to be a little bit lighter here along that top edge. Then the handles are a darker wood on this particular basket. Then I just highlight the up here with, I'll highlight it with the same thing that I'm using on my basket. That'll make it all kind of marry really well. It goes together. This is my I can just brace my little finger on the canvas there to do my little highlight. And then on the underneath side of that handle, then I want to make that a little bluer. So it gives a feeling of round. And then the core shadows darker. And I'll do the same here. So you can see I can use the corner of that brush to make a smaller, narrower brush stroke. Keep my brush clean so my colors stay clean. That copper pot behind there is still wet, so I can use that. I can pull some of that paint in to shape my handle there. Make that a little bit darker right back here. And then I want the highlight. Again, I brace my finger on the unpainted part of the canvas. And there we go. There's that handle. I'm going to use a little bit smaller brush now to make that blue along the edge of the canvas. And I can just brace my left hand here. Make the blue along the edge of the handle. I said, there we go. There we are, just so that rounds out. And then this edge will be a little bit lighter here. Get a nice highlight. There's our croissant basket. Now, I'll do my napkin. Well, I guess actually I could do the croissants next. My croissant mixtures are my mud plus cadmium orange plus a little bit of cadmium red light plus some, for the lighter mixtures, plus some white. So my croissants, I start blocking in here. I'll start going to a smaller brush that's a little bit too big. I like to use the largest brush I possibly can, but then when it gets to be too big, then I have to go smaller. But they, and the light hits on these. And since that pastry is rough and uneven, has little folds and stuff in it, I let that. Don't want this real smooth. But I follow the shape of the croissant with my brush. These are round, so I just follow that shape. Now on this side where these go underneath, I'm going to just cool it just a little bit where it goes back there. Just to give it some coolness there so that it goes, it rounds the croissant. This is really fun. I've never painted any pastries like this, so it's a fun experience for me. This is why I love collaborating with my collectors, because I get to do all sorts of paintings that I never would have done otherwise. This makes for really fun. Now I'm going to, I didn't put enough white paint out. I'm out of white. I need to make a little lighter highlight on these. So let me mix a little white into my lightest mixture here. I usually mix all of my colors out beforehand, but I just didn't get this one light enough. So here's, this is a little bit lighter. Again, the light's coming in from the left. Now we've got this, there's croissant here. Darker as it comes, it'll come under this fold of the napkin. That's just going to be a white linen napkin. I go ahead and bring some blue on this side of my croissant there. And then this one back here, I'm going to put a little color on that. But you can see I sketched these out pretty much the anatomy, I don't know, but just the basic shapes of the croissant so I would have that to follow as I paint. Put a little blue onto this one. I'll finish them out once I get my napkin. This one I want to put a little blue because I want it to go back. I want it to go back behind that one. Then this will be lighter here. Okay. Now my napkin. These are mixtures of, this is mud plus white. And then this is also little more, that same mixture with more white in it. It gets darker here where the croissant kind of casts a shadow down over that, with the napkin. And then this is also darker down here. Then this is my mud plus a little bit of cadmium orange. A lot of white, a little bit of mud, and just a tiny bit of cadmium orange. I want to make this a warmer white than what is up here on the awning. That awning, actually, with the green stripes are viridian green. And I've actually added a little tiny bit of viridian green into that white so that it cools it down. Then this is warmer because it has some orange in it. And then I'll bring a little bit of pure white onto this. So that makes this napkin come forward of the white back there. And the top of this napkin catches the light here. And then my croissant, actually, that shadow casts down like that. And my napkin gets a little bit brighter there. And the top of this napkin, I'm going to use my mix with the cadmium orange in there first. A little bit of, then add my pure white up here. This napkin comes up. That actually, there's needs to go over the edge of the basket. This is going to curve a little bit. It comes out over the edge of the basket. Okay, now this croissant then. I have my reference material on the laptop next to my easel. And I have a bunch of different pictures of croissants, so I can kind of look at them and decide what I'm going to do here. It's a little bit too light because I want it to stand out against my white napkin. But again, I pull my brush strokes in the direction of the pastry. And I can use the brush flat to then get that feeling. Now, where those little edges of the croissant go over, I use a little darker. I listen to music while people have asked me, you know, what do I listen to while I paint? I listen to music a lot of times, but I also listen to motivational tapes, or I guess they're on YouTube. They're not tapes anymore these days. But Denzel Washington is one of my favorites, and also I've never watched the Oprah Winfrey Show, but I discovered some of her motivational speeches on YouTube. And she's an excellent speaker. She's a very motivational speaker. And she had a suggestion about something that I've started doing. She said she keeps a gratitude journal, which is you write down everything that you're thankful for. And so I keep it by my bed, and at night she suggested at least 5 things at night. Just sit down and what were 5 things that you're thankful for during the day. And I've started doing that, and that's really a wonderful way to review your day and just thank God for the gifts that He's given us. I mean, we're just so blessed, and it really has helped me be aware of how blessed I am. It's just a wonderful way, and I thank Oprah Winfrey for that, because that's just a great way to thank God for what He's given us. So anyway, this is the way that I paint my croissants. I have a little bit more work to do, but I just kind of wanted to show you how this does. I'm going to use some more pure white on my napkin here. Just these linen napkins. I originally thought about doing a checked one there, but I thought, no, this is more French. Czech would probably look more Italian. So this is, we want this edge to catch the light as it comes, folds and comes. comes down there. Anyway, I really appreciate you watching my YouTube videos. Also, visit my blog. The link is in the description below. The address is also on the final frame of my YouTube video. You can subscribe both to my YouTube videos and also to my blog. You'll get an email, a notification every time that I make a new post or do a new video. And I just really appreciate you watching. Feel free to ask questions in the comment section. And you just have a wonderful, wonderful day. And just remember, thank God for something.